good, YouTube? It's your boy Dev back again for another first listen to my nigga Plizzaint. And today we're gonna take a listen to the new album from Post Malone called Stoney. Now, I've been on Post Malone for a minute, man. It's been like, what, a year and a half? Yeah, probably been like 2 years now. We first came out with White Iverson, and I remember, you know, everybody was like, damn, this new dude coming out. Got a song called White Iverson. It's kind of funny, but it's also kind of catchy. And I didn't think it was funny at all the first time I heard it. I mean, he definitely has a basketball influence because he always, you know, mentioning artists, I mean, players like Monte Ellis. You know, he got a song named after Monte Ellis. And then, you know, he talking about White Iverson and, you know, talking about, you know, jump shots and shit like that. So he definitely got a basketball influence in him. White Iverson was definitely a hit. I can't even lie, fucks with that shit. I see on here you got a couple tracks I already listened to though. You know, White Iverson being one. Too Young, that's probably my favorite Post Malone track ever. Too Young is that shit. And then Go Flex, I already heard of Go Flex. And Deja Vu, I got a video down below. Y'all click the link and see that video. Deja Vu, I thought that was a good little mix. So he's all over the place, man. I don't see why people say that he's a bad artist. Like, some people really don't like Post Malone, but I feel like you gotta have a different vibe if you fucking with Post, so. But with that being said though, man, hey, been fucking talking too much. Let's just get right into this. We got Post Malone, Stoney. Y'all ready? All right, we got track one. Broken what? Broken wine, I drank wine last night. Broken whiskey glass. That Texas South vibe. Hey, okay. Track right there, you know, I remember on the mixtape, August 26th, yeah, he did that mixtape, and he did, like, a little country, he did two country songs on there, had a little country vibe to it, not bad, you know, I was like, he's trying something different, so, you know, it was, like, something different, so I was like, oh, shit, okay, but on this track right, he switched it up, you know, at first, I was sitting there, like, okay, what is this, you know, this is a weird intro, but then he switched it up, and I was like, okay, oh, here go the Post right here, bringing that, that feel-good music, you feel me, but, you know, just an overall decent track. Gonna take a couple more listens to the fuck with it, but decent track. All right, we got track two, Big Lie. Okay. Alright, man, so my opinions on that track, man. Hey, definitely having Mustard on the beat was definitely a good addition. I like that track. You know, definitely one of them, you know, the Post Malone tracks we used to, you know, the hype. He got that, it's like that wavy, he got the wavy flow, you know, like, it's just everything. You know, some of those artists that you listen to, is just they got that vibe to them. It's just like, bro, you a cool ass nigga. Like, and I feel like that's what Post Malone, you know, he just wavy out here. Just silky smooth, in the word of Zohan, silky smooth. All right, track three, we got Deja Vu. I already did a review to it, you know, put the link in down below, y'all can click on it. You know, like I said, I like that track, you know, Bieber being on there with the vocals, it was definitely a good addition. And then, you know, Post Malone got some vocals too. Now, don't sleep on Post. Post definitely got some vocals on them, and you know, both of their vocals put together just equaled a good track, man. It was a really good track. I liked it a lot. Alright, track four, we got No Option. Oh, oh my god. I can't show up at this spot and now everyone they are watching. No one to prove you wrong, but see you leave me with no option. Yeah, see you leave me with no option. Okay. Hey, let me know in the comments below who produced that shit, cause that motherfucker beat at the beginning. But definitely, like I said, Post Malone, talented artist, man. He got his vocals in there. His vocals is really good, man. Very underrated, I say. In my opinion, everybody just think, you know, in all honesty, everybody just thinks that Post Malone is like a rapper, but he can't be put under that rapper category. You know what I'm saying? Like he do quite a bit of both. You feel me? Like he's that hybrid. But that track right there, I thought that was just Justin Bieber for a minute. I was like, this nigga sound just like Bieber. Let me know if y'all felt the same way down below, cause I thought that nigga sounded like Bieber, which is not a bad thing, cause you know, you know, the whole damn world a believer. So you feel me? All right, track 5, Cold. Honestly think that I listened to this track, but we gonna let me refresh my memory. That shit that you go to like one of them house music clubs and that shit playing right there, like I feel like he's just hitting every genre right now. Popular genre, let's put it that way. Popular genre right now, he's hitting every what's that, with the country, he got the house, he got, you know, he got DJ Mustard. I just don't know, man. I feel like Post Malone, a lot of people hate Post Malone. You just gotta feel him, man. Like, he just, this man just having a good time. He enjoying himself. And he got a little bit of talent in him. You know what I'm saying? Like, with singing and rapping, you know, like, that takes some talent. You feel me? And to make it sound good. All right, we got track 6. Obviously, everybody in the goddamn world know this track, White Iverson. So, let it ride for a little bit, you know. Hey. USF baller, baby. We got track 7, I Fall Apart. Track, obviously somebody done tore this nigga down because he's singing the blues right there. That track was definitely different from all the other tracks. It was, he had a little bit of hurt in him. You could hear it in his voice. And he was talking about somebody. Got all these thoughts in his phone, drinking. You said it. You said it, girl, that we be together. You said it. So I feel where you're coming from, damn. So that's another side of Post Malone that well, the hardcore fans probably are used to, but you know, to casual fans, something that's just a little different for us. We got track 8, Patient. My opinion on that track, definitely one of those tracks where it's just like, you know, Post Malone, we gotta be in that mood. He obviously, from Fall Apart to Patient, he feeling some type of way. That's what I think, he feeling some type of way, like, someone done hurt him. Someone definitely done hurt him. Alright, we got track 9, Go Flex. I've already heard this track, so, you know, I'll let it play for a little bit, man. Get a pussy or a car, man, I just wanna go flex. So, I know for real though, on that track though, I like how he had implemented the guitar in there. I fucked with that when I first heard it. I was like, damn, okay, he put the guitar in here? Like, you know, he trying to keep that, he from Texas, right? Yeah, he's from Texas. He's trying to keep that South vibe. And I like that. That Southpaw shit, you feel me? He trying to keep that implemented in his work and, you know, rep your city. Track 10, Feel, featuring... featuring the girl that cheated on me, a.k.a. Kyrie Irving. Bitch done cheated on me. I got me a motherfucking ring. You saw the A. Y'all saw that shit though? Y'all saw what I did? Motherfucker, first of all, I hit the step back on that nigga Steph. Pulled on that bitch, yak cat, pointed at the bench. Give me that one ring. Then I came Christmas Day, hitting the motherfucking spin around, came Kobe! Fuck that nigga, man. You know what I'm saying? Fuck them light skinned ass niggas, man. Team Kyrie, baby. Minus all the shenanigans, you know, from Kalani, I can't lie, she got talent, you know what I'm saying? Like, it is what it is, she got talent, she definitely can sing her ass off, and as an artist, you know, I respect her music, you know, I don't respect the message she was giving in the first, you know, her first, like, mixtape little thing she had, when, you know, about cheating and shit like that, I don't, but, you know, talent-wise, she definitely got it, okay, hands down, Kalani, you got it, but you cheated on me, so fuck you. And Post Malone, as obvious, got the vocals, man. It's just, you just got the vocals, bro. Like, this is not even a rap album. This is like a R&B album, for real, in all honesty. It's like a different type of R&B. And we got track 11, Too Young, my favorite Post Malone track. For real, like, this bitch is hard. Like, the first time I heard this shit, like 2 years ago, it was at a party. I was fucked up. I was like, oh, shit. This part came on. I just wanna go cop me some, hit Fairfax, go shopping though. She didn't wanna hit the bathroom. Yeah, I'm sitting here like, I need a pop a door. From when I'm trying to go look, I'm finding you by the door. And I'm on. Hey, I was fucked up, I was like, she's trying to keep me cool. I'm sitting here, you know. Yeah. I don't wanna lie to you. I don't wanna lie to you. When I'm getting down. there like, dang, bro, this nigga singing to me, dog. Like, this, I feel this nigga. I ain't never going back for real. I don't want to die too young. Maybe old. I ain't dying too young. Fuck that. All right, we got track 12, Congratulations, featuring Quavo. I also heard this track, too. I'm not even going to front on y'all. See, hey, look, if I don't listen to a track already, I ain't going to lie to y'all, man. Fuck, why I need to lie for it? This ain't no act. Shit don't do nothing for me sitting here listening to a song I already heard on the camera. You know, that shit no fun. Bitch, I done 180 videos. You think that videos would be fun if I motherfucking already heard shit? But yeah, man, so that track right there, when I first heard it, I wasn't feeling it, but, you know, it had Quavo in it, so, and I fucks with Quavo. I like Quavo. I mean, I feel like they got the funny flow. Ripping in the bit in the center. Feeling with the bit in the center. You feel like he got that flow. That's just funny. I fuck with Quavo. Every time a track featuring Quavo, I gotta fuck with it, see what it sound like. But everything else, man, that track was a decent track. It wasn't a bad track. Definitely not better than most of the tracks on here, but it was a decent track. We got track 13, Up There. So my opinions on that track, man, it reminded me of an old R&B song. I couldn't put my mind to it. If y'all can put your mind to it, let me know in the comments below. But I just didn't. But yeah, man, I just couldn't think about what track it was. It was slipping my mind like crazy. Damn. But definitely a good track, man. I like it to feel good. You got the vibe. It's definitely, like I said, it's not a rap album. It's just what it is. Not a rap album. At least that's what I think. All right, we got track 14. Yours truly, Austin Post. Alright, we got track 15, Leave. On that track, that's probably the one track that I did not like at all. Like, no question about it. I just wasn't feeling that shit. That was, I don't know. It was that beat was, you know, I know he was doing the southern beat, whatever, sounded like something from Texas, and but it just didn't mix well. I didn't like it. Track 16, Hit This Hard. Weird track right there, but I fucked with it. Once the beat dropped, I fucked with it. I was like, okay, this. At first, I wasn't feeling it though. To tell you the truth, I wasn't feeling it at first. But then the beat dropped, I see he was doing there. He's being experimental. Can't hate on that one. Can't hate on that one. All right, track 17, Money Made Me Do It, featuring 2 Chainz. I've heard this already. For real though, I've heard that track already, so like I said, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. That track right there, I liked it because it implemented the steel drums in there and had a little island feel to it. And then 2 Chainz came in. You know, 2 Chainz just do his thing. You know, 2 Chainz just does 2 Chainz. I don't know how to really explain that. Y'all know what the fuck I mean. But yeah, man, I fucks with it. I like that track. That was a good track too. Definitely, you know, had that feel. It was like a little good feel. Feel good music. Wavy as fuck ass nigga. Silky smooth. Word to the Zohan. That's what Post Malone is. And we got the last track, track 18, Feeling Whitney. Who's Whitney? Oh, against your cold. Alright, man, so for that track right there, definitely he feeling some type of way. Like I said, with the Kalani track as well. And, what is it called? Fell Apart? Where is it? I Fall Apart, yeah. So he definitely feeling some type of way in some of these tracks. You know, somebody, heard him. Yeah, I would say, you know, he plays the guitar, or someone's playing the guitar. He sings, he fucking raps, rhymes in a melodic way. I don't know what Post Malone be doing. He just make good music now. I fucks with it. It takes certain people to fucks with Post Malone albums and, you know, his music. And some people gonna fuck with it, some people not, you know. But that's what music's about. We all relate to it in our own way. And, you know, no one's wrong, because what's gold to you can be gold to somebody else, could be coal to somebody else. So, you know, it just depends on how you feel about it. I mean, and that's all that really matters, what you feel about it. So, how I feel about it, though. You know, as I always said, 18 tracks is a lot of tracks. I feel like, you know, he should cut that down to like 13, 12. It would have been a fucking fire album if he kept it down to 12. Still a good album, though. Still a good album. Probably two, three tracks I didn't like, and those being like, you know, being neutral, I don't know. It was one track I really didn't like, which was, I think it was Leave. I think it was called Leave. Yeah, Leave or Hit Hard. Hit This Hard. It was either one that I didn't really like. But, yeah, then there was two questionable ones that it was like, okay, I feel it, but then I might not feel it. But, you know, it's going to take a couple of listens sometimes, you know, for you to really feel a track. But the rest of the tracks were really good. You know, that being said, though, I've already heard like seven of the tracks. You know, like White Iverson and Too Young has been out for probably like a year and a half. Money Made Me Do It was out for a while. You know, Deja Vu just came out. So, you know, it was a lot of tracks that, you know, he's already used. So it wasn't fairly new to me. But, I mean, those tracks are some of the tracks I really enjoyed. So, Too Young is being my favorite Post Malone track ever. But, yeah, man, it was just a good-ass album. I mean, I don't see why people disliked it. Like, I liked it. it's just a wavy-ass album. That's all it is. Wavy-ass album. Post Malone got the vocals. He knows how to rhyme. He knows how to rap. It's just, I don't understand why people would dislike it. I could see some people, like, not liking his auto-tune. But, I mean, the man can still blow. You know, like, he can still sing. I don't understand why. It's not just the auto-tune. It may be a little voice altercations right there. But, I mean, for the most part, it's him singing. So, I don't know why people don't really like it. But, you know, Post Malone from Texas. You know, just bringing that old Southern Texas country vibe to it. So, I fucks with it. I mean, I like what he's doing. He's definitely a talented artist. So, fuck what everybody else saying. That's just how I feel about it. It's my fucking opinion. So, I can say what the fuck I want on my fucking channel. But like always, hey, been fucking talking too much. This has been your boy, Dev. Don't forget, like, comment, subscribe, share, you know, retweet the video. Do whatever y'all want, as always. Thank y'all for supporting. You know, y'all the best 50K bunch out there. And until the next time, we out. This has been your boy, Dev. I said that already again. God damn it.